Good afternoon. I am Sonam Singh, student manager of BIMHRD. I am glad to introduce Mr. Umesh Revankar. Mr. Umesh Revankar holds a bachelor degree in business management from Mangalore University and MBA in finance. He had attended advanced management program at Harvard Business School. Mr. Revankar started his career with Shriram Group as an executive trainee in the year 1987. He is with Shriram Group for last 30 years and processor executive experience in the finance service industry. He has grown with the organization and at present he is managing director and CEO of Shriram Transport Finance Company Limited. During his stint with the group, he has shouldered various responsibility and worked in several key roles of business operations. Shriram Transport Finance Company Limited is a flagship company of Shriram Group. He was the past president of Federation of Indian Hire Purchase Association. He is director in Finance Industry Development Council. Dear sir, please enlighten us with your words of wisdom. This is all yours.
Very nice to meet all of you, youngsters, future of India. Looking at you, I feel that I'm little very boring finance companies because people who are in finance and banks are supposed to be boring. They're not very interesting, colorful. So there are so many professions available. Among them, this doesn't make that very interesting. I was born in a very middle-class family, I should say. My father was a scientist in CFTRI, Central Food Research Institute. So, born in a middle-class family, my upbringing has been very modest. In our family, the way we have grown up was more of a socialistic approach. For example, I'd like to tell you, if somebody is ill in my house, everyone will have same food. If it is a curd rice, everybody will have curd rice. If it is a sandwich, everybody will have a sandwich. That was the kind of socialism was there in our house. And it was practiced by everyone, including my father. And that kind of environment gave us a comfort of sharing, understanding, empathizing. These are the few things which I learned in my home in the initial days. Once I completed my education, I joined Shriram Group. Fortunately for me, I should say it was a very good joining because I had not left it. Last 30 years, I am in Shriram. Again, that's boring for you. Working for a single company is not a professionalism, is what some of you may feel. But let me talk about it a little later. I was a keen sportsman in my younger days. I used to represent college in football, cricket, and hockey, all three games. And being a sportsman, I have learned several things in my life. Many of my today's ability to adjust, adopt, bringing in attitude and trying to be best, trying to be good. These sports have inculcated that habit in me. I used to love to be a forward in football because I can score a goal and get credits. But I always settled down for midfield. So I can move to back and forward both. Whether it's football or hockey, I always settle down for what is more needed for the team. Even in cricket, I tried to be as a more of all-rounder, trying to suit a spot than wanted to be, even when I was captain. Friends, this is how the attitude gets developed. Now, let me talk about my career in Shriram. I joined in 87 and first 1 year I was in Chennai for some time. In fact, I left Mangalore. I am from Mangalore. And moved to Mumbai. Because every Mangalorean, if you at all you know, they move to either Mumbai or Pune for a job. They don't stay back because Mangalore do not have enough of us, opportunity and scope. I never thought that I would be going to Chennai or even to Bangalore. Because our direction is always northwards. I got selected in Shriram. Some 3-4 companies I got selected. But Shriram is, I joined because they told me that they'll give you accommodation. In Bombay, I was finding it difficult to get accommodation proper. So I had to stay in relative's house. I joined Shriram, luckily, because Shriram had the same middle-class value. The value system was middle-class. And the promoter, founder of this company, Mr. R. Tyagarajan, he believed in socialistic values. And because he was a believer in socialistic values, over the period, we also developed that attitude. And finally, he told in the initial period of the journey that people of this company, the employees, some of you will become partner and part owner of the group. In fact, it came true. Oh, 5-6 years back when we created ownership trust, I became part owner of the group. And what he said, he delivered. And now we need to deliver because he did it. Now how that journey happened, we have to understand. During the crisis, we had a crisis in Shriram Group in 1998. We were a deposit-taking company. We are even now. There was one or two failures in NBFCs. Then it was a crisis situation because we did not have any other source of resources for lending and doing business. 90% of our resources was dependent on deposits. Then he told us, we have to go and convince customers, depositors, that your deposit is safe. It is not only the failure of one or two NBFCs that mattered. Even the central bank came out with a paper advertisement saying that don't deposit in Shriram. And that's the time all of us leaders met our customers, brokers, individual agents who were procuring business for us and build a trust with the customer. We managed it for next 2 years, 98 to 2000, was a very crucial period. And we could make, not only we survived, we grew after that. After that, we found a different way of building businesses. We partnered with banks. We partnered with MNC Bank, Citibank. We partnered with some manufacturing companies. We raised resources. We did not do business in our books. We did business in bank book. We demonstrated that we are not only good in lending, we are also equally good in collection. And our ability to lend, build relationship with customer, collect the money, manage the portfolio, that got appreciated by every bank. And slowly, we started getting funds. From 2003 to 2006 was a time we got a lot of resources from the banks and we were able to develop our businesses. We were around 1,000 crores in year 2000. 1,000 crores. Today, our asset under management is 80,000 crores. It grew because of the trust and confidence what we built with the customer and with the bank and institution. This is a message for every one of you that a ground level trust building between customer and then with an institution and talking about it at various forums makes a big difference in the institution and also with the careers of our people. Now, friends, you may try to understand what is this lending business about. Shriram today is not only in lending, we are in insurance business, we are in general insurance, we are in life insurance, we are in mutual funds, we are in stock broking, we are in real estate, we are in EPC businesses. There are so many other businesses. But this Shriram Transport Finance Company, which I handle, is the largest company. We are also in SME lending. We are also into personal loan, two-wheeler loan, car loan, so many things. There are two companies which handle that. Both are listed companies. Now, few are the things which you have to learn is by doing yourself. I joined as a management trainee or executive trainee. I could have been at higher pedestal and directing. But what I inculcated was going to the field and be myself part of the team, with the field team. This is a very, very vital for anyone to understand and grow. If you are not able to understand, then you have a difficulty when there is a crisis. Now, be it, in fact, in some of these days, when I was young, when I was a bank manager in Mangalore, I remember when I went to one of the depositors' house, those days, people who retired, we used to take the list of people who retired and go and canvass for deposits. In fact, one of the person, before entering the gate, he asked me, from where are you? And when I told that I'm from a finance company, he asked me, get lost from the gate. So this kind of sales experience makes you very, very humble. And we were part of, I was always, whenever there was a challenge of reposition, I used to be the front man in getting the vehicle repossessed if there's a difficulty in repossessing. There are many times I went and sat in a truck myself for reposition. It is not that we use muscle man for reposition. The team member itself, the staff themselves will go if there's any difficulty in recovery and demonstrate that it is possible to recover money in very peaceful manner. There are many other companies which will just outsource it. Any difficult job, they'll outsource it. Especially if you look at MNC style of functioning, any routine job outsource, any difficult job outsource, anything you feel it will be a burden on you is outsource. So the modern management is outsourcing a difficult job, then keep a margin and building the business, which we have not done. Our philosophy has been do it yourself, then lead. Show and lead how to manage particular situation. That's how this organization has been built. A few points which I would like to tell you before because I understand that you will be very keen to talk to me by asking questions rather than just listening to me. Few things which I would like to tell you that don't take it as advice, you just take it in the corner of your mind and have it. One is always true to be yourself. Don't try to be somebody else. It's easy to copy, it is to emulate, easy to get influenced. You should. It is not that I don't get influenced, I also get influenced. But you should be yourself. That gives you identity and that gives you separate place. Then don't use shortcuts. There are always climbers, those who call climbers. Climbers are people who jump on somebody's shoulders to reach higher places. That is not going to help you. It will help you in shortcut, help you in the short term. It may give you places, but it is not going to give you a long-term sustainable place or is a long-term sustainable role in a company or in a society. And this, you may not like it, don't chase money. Let the money chase you. This is because today the comparison is how much is others got? What is the CTC, somebody else is getting? So this is where often talked about in the campus. I feel you go behind your passion, what you like, and don't jump companies for the sake of jumping, for the sake of hike. That is not going to get you anywhere. I have seen many people who have jumped. They have jumped and jumped and jumped, but no upper movement. It is a lateral movement. So if you jump more, because the moment they see you have jumped after three companies, the fourth company will think that you are not going to stay here or you are not going to be anything contributing to the company. So they all are looking at contribution to the organization. And as I was telling you, always have a ground reality by yourself, whatever position you are in. The three things which I would like to, in the letter which I received from the management, I saw discipline, dedication, and determination are the three things, core values. I would like to add two things. I feel a teamwork, passion, and sharing are the most important. Added to that, or maybe these three, I feel as personally important. Always be a team player. Don't try to be aloof. Moment you try to be aloof, then you have no support. A teamwork makes you a successful. You always try to build team around you. Always be a part of the team. And second is passion. You have to develop passion for whatever field you are getting into. It need not be the field which you initially wanted to go. It can be any field you go. Build passion. You look at all the best sportsmen in India. They have a great passion. Whether it's Kapil Dev, Gavaskar, Sachin, Dravid, or Virat, or you take tennis players like Payas, Vijay Amritraj, Ramesh Krishnan. They had great passion. And they always beat an opponent who were much, much above their ranking when they played for the country, especially in the Davis Cup or in the cricket. So that what makes them click is the passion, dedication, and the great passion, the love what they have for the job or career or whatever field. It can be even NGO. It need not be a corporate field. And the third one is sharing. Ability to communicate, share. I just understood, heard something about the communication. I feel your ability to communicate and share is very, very important. Why I'm telling you this is, we learned from our founder, promoter, Mr. Tyagarajan. He could have taken entire wealth by himself because he founded the company. He need not have created a trust. He did not have created a group of employees to share his wealth. He took same portion as we seniors. He identified few seniors and he shared an equal share of company's wealth in the form of share, not in cash. So that is the kind of equal sharing. I think that made us contribute a great to the organization. Finally, as we are entering into new era of employment, there are a few challenges for every one of you. What are these challenges? Challenges are from the AI, artificial intelligence, where human learning is copied and done better than human. Then there is a machine learning, ML, where machine keeps learning by itself because of repetition and improves and predict what is the next move. And the third is IoT, the Internet of Things, where different sensors in the machines and different movement, that makes things more learning and it can do a lot of things on its own because of prediction. Because of algorithm and so much of input getting in, so much of data getting captured, All those things, these three things are going to create a challenge for many of us, people who are seeking employment. So how to be better than that, how to manage those things are going to be a challenge for this generation. For our generation, we are almost at the fag end, so it may not be hurting. But for you, you need to come over these three things, the AI, ML and IoT. So how you are, your skills are to manage those things and develop your ability to do a business or do activity which can contribute to the society and make you benefit. These are going to be the challenge, and I feel the younger generation are extremely intelligent, very quick, very good in grasp. You will be able to do a great job is what I feel. With this, I wish you all the best and probably ready for question and answer.
Sir, my question to you is, in 98 when government also said not to invest in Shriram, how did you build that trust among customers?
See, building that trust in the customer is talking about your business, what is your business model and how you utilize your money. And we were able to connect to each of the customers because we were ready on the field to meet each one of them. And we had an agency force which we talked to them, motivated them. We had well-organized meetings and communicated that this is an aberration. Because of some company failure, it should not be bearing on us. Why I'm telling you this is, the companies which failed, they did not have a proper lending model, lending and collection model, but we had. So we communicated that to the individual depositors and we were able to win the trust. And you won't believe, the renewals were all-time high. When deposit comes from end, after 1 year or 2 years, it gets renewed. And during that period, the renewals were much higher than normal period. So we had a good renewal, also fresh deposit coming in. So that helped us in that crucial 1 or 2 years. But by the time you could clarify to RBI about our business, our management, and they were happy. And they recertified us within a short period. So it was a short period, but the negative impact we were able to manage because of our ability to reach out to the customer and build a trust with them.
Sir, my question to you is, what is the impact of demonetization and GST in your company?
Maybe a popular question. See, demonetization was a sudden and it had a big impact for the customers. Because you suck the money, because entire trucking business was done through cash. Why cash? You have to understand why cash was used. They were delivering the goods. When they are delivering the goods, before starting the truck, they get a cash for the expenses that are incurred for filling the petrol or giving to the driver, and 2 or 3 days which they spend on the highways. Now, because of that, advance was paid in cash. Then the balance amount, when he reaches to the destination, he gets a chalan or check. He again would discount it because for return, he needs cash. So what happened is 100% of a transaction was in cash for a transporter. And it was practiced like that. So suddenly when you say that money is not available, luckily they did not restrict on usage of a petroleum product. That saved. So our customers were able to adopt and shift to what I should say, to some extent to digital mode of transfer of money. And we were ready. Luckily, we were ready with the app. Because our app was ready 1 year back, but it was not popular. Where we had different payment gateways linked. So he could transfer the money to us through any payment gateway. And we encourage people to download the app. But unfortunately for our truckers, 30% of them only had smartphones. 70% do not have a smartphone. So that's the only thing which restricted. But we manage for 2-3 months, then things become little normal. But the impact to the economy was bad. When I say economy was bad, you look the farmers, most of them were used to sell their product in cash only. And suddenly some farmers were discomforted when they were selling, they are not getting cash, but they were getting old currency, which farmers were petrified, I should say, not very comfortable in taking an old currency. A farmer could have easily collected old currency and deposited into bank, nobody would have questioned him. But many farmers I know, they did not accept old currency and they wanted a new currency. So they postponed their sales. As they postponed their sales, prices came down, they had to sell at a discount for a new currency. So that was a negative for farmers and that was negative for rural economy. So I believe the rural economy suffered, the small industries suffered due to demonetization, which I feel now it has become normal. And as far as the GST is concerned, I feel it was a necessary change. Anytime it brought in, same disruption would have been there. Any government, any time. Only thing is, maybe the way this government has put multiple slabs and all, that could have been avoided. But the government also had a very short time to prepare. They wanted to implement at any cost. And since there are 28 states and different slabs, everybody has to be happy. Every finance minister of the state has to be happy. They tried to accommodate everyone. When you are trying to accommodate many people, you have challenges of implementation. And I believe this implementation will get smoothened in another 2 or 3 months, maybe 6 months. Now, only thing is, what will happen to the informal economy, which is dependent on cash, or their market is cash, their buying is cash, that is going to be a challenge to study. I feel the formal economy will benefit. The companies like Hindustan Liver and all will benefit it. But if there is a soap manufacturing company in the just backyard of your house, small industry or cottage industry, they will be suffering. They will get all their inputs at high cost. The labor can become high cost tomorrow and their marketing skill will be limited to local. They will not be able to sell. So I think the small industries will be going to suffer for a short time till they adopt and adjust towards GST and their ability to account it, get input credit for all their product. Because ultimately, if you are able to get input credit, you are able to be as good as big. Yeah, Hindustan Lever or a small company will not make any difference as long as they are able to get input credit. So I think that management and going to that level is going to be a challenge. And government, I feel, need to go a little out of the way to support small manufacturers because 80% of the employment in India is generated by small enterprises. Big enterprises do not generate employment. They may invest 1 lakh crore, but employment generation will be very, very small, dismal. But the same amount you invest in smaller companies, they generate employment. How many of our Indian population is skilled to get employment? They are not like you. You are elite people. You are able to get better education. You are able to get better job. But there are many, many people. So 80% of the employment comes from informal sector. 45% of the export of India is done by informal sector. There should be some support to them. And Maharashtra government, I read somewhere, they are wanting to give back 60 to 80% of the tax they collected. If every government does that to small enterprises, I think the small enterprises will flourish and do well. And the social unrest due to unemployment will stop. Otherwise, there could be a challenge the way we manage the country, is what I feel personally. It's a personal opinion.
Sir, I do one question. For a marketer, it has been always difficult to win the trust of a customer, especially when your product or a service is new to the market as compared to rivals, or especially if it is related to finance, because people hesitate to invest. They think 10 times more before investing. So my question is how to win in this situation, that you are new to the market and again your product or a service is related to the finance.
Yeah. So one thing is very, very important. what I told is try to be true to yourself. Try to be open with the customer and talk about your company and you both. You have to sell yourself first, then company. If you are trying to sell directly product, you will be failed. So you have to win the trust individually, then talk about the product and features of the product and what are the safeguards behind the product. So I think if you are able to do that well, you are able to sell well and you will be a good salesman, any product for that matter. It sometimes wrong product also gets sold, but you will not last long. If you at all in financial services, you have to last very long. Then you have to be honest and you have to be truly defending the product properly and giving the utilities or use of the product yourself.
Thank you, sir. It was indeed a pleasure to have you here, and your words of wisdom has really added up to our knowledge. We will surely learn from your experiences and apply them in our future corporate career. Thank you.